Are you thinking about getting a 3D printer and your wife or your husband don't think you need it? Or maybe your parents don't want to buy you one or bring it into the house because they don't see a need for it. Well, I fix things all the time with my 3D printer. Not just print little knickknacks, I fix stuff with it. It's a handy tool. And here's a project I want to show you guys that I designed in Tinkercad, a free software, printed out of my Ender 3, and fixed a problem. So maybe you can show them this project and help convince them to let you get a 3D printer. I'll show you all the details right here on Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. The problem starts in my basement with this plug plate. The wall itself is designed for drywall, but there was paneling put in place. So when I put this on the plug, I have too much of a gap behind it. So I 3D printed this frame, which takes up the space, and this fits inside of it. Let me show you the wall to better explain what the issue is. Here's the wall in question. You can see that the switch plate is really, really loose, and there's this gap behind it. You can even get little fingers behind it, which is not safe. So I'm using Tinkercad, tinkercad.com. It's a free software, and I use it a lot. And all I'm gonna do is drop a pyramid here, resize it to close to what I need. I'll end up readjusting this in a minute. Using the ruler tool, I get full dimensions. Then I'm gonna use this block tool, which is hollow. It takes away material. I'm gonna lift it up 10 millimeters because I'm gonna cut the top of this triangle off. So I'll make it bigger to cover the whole triangle and slide it just about to the middle. Now I want the angles to be a little steeper. So I'm gonna grab the top of the triangle, pull it all the way up, and that looks pretty good. And then I'll take this hollow box, make it bigger because it's gonna cut the whole top of this thing off. Then I'll grab both those, group them together, and here's the base for my insert. Now I need to cut out the center of this to go around the electrical box behind the cover plate. And I've got those dimensions, so it's 66 by 106. But I realized I needed to make this a little bit bigger, but I'll show you that in a minute. So here's the cover plate as another hollow box because I'm going to recess it. So I made the base bigger. Now I take that same cutout, center it in the X and Y direction. Now I'll group these two together to cut it out. So here I click group. Now I've got the frame. Now I want to recess the top of this for the cover plate. This box is the same size as the cover plate, so I'll drop it on top and then I'm going to lower it just a few millimeters to make the recess. So first it's centered, and now I'll grab it, grab the arrow, drop it, and I think I'm 7 millimeters. Yeah, 7 millimeters off the top, and I'm going to group these together and that'll form the recess that I want. And there it is. Very simple design. And now I just bring it into Cura. I'm going to slice it with my Magic 0.28 profile, so 0.28 layer height. 10% infill is all I need. I sliced this guy and it says it only take 1 hour and 50 minutes, and to be accurate, it took 3 hours. So this thing was way off. But it's a real basic print. I go through the layers. This should print real easy. So here's a time lapse of it printing on the Ender 3. It fit on the Ender 3, so a sub $200 printer can print this easy. I'm using my Filament Friday white filament and it comes out beautiful. Now I'll test the cover plate. Fits in just the way I wanted. So now I just need to remove this and install it into the wall. I use my removal tool from my Filament Friday toolkit. The back of this thing is smooth, but it's going to go against the wall. Who cares? The front looks really good. So here's the plug. Now just remove the cover plate, and then I'll install this frame. So here's the frame, slides right over it. I left enough gap that I can position this. The cover plate will actually hold this in place. It's going to pinch it to the wall. So I'll just tighten this guy up, and then I'll position the frame around it. So I'm off a little bit. There we go, snapped in place. And now when I tighten the screw all the way, the cover plate will actually push against this frame and hold it in place. And now that it's there, no more gap, no little fingers can get behind it, problem solved. I know this is a simple and very boring, very dad project 3D print, but it's very useful. This is something I just can't go to the store and buy, and it fixed a problem, even if it's temporary. That's what a 3D printer gives you. So maybe it'll help convince them to let you get a 3D printer. And then of course, once you do, in between the dad projects, you can tinker with it and play with it, print all kinds of cool things, but then go back and print this once in a while just to make them happy. So maybe this will help you get that 3D printer you're looking for. If it does, let me know in the comments below.